Starting live video.
Yeah.
What's
the time,
Morgan? Yeah, we're live.
Okay. Hi everybody, welcome to Moulsecoomb and Bevendean.
Yep, we're going to take you on a live tour around the public artworks that we've installed here in Moulsecoomb and Bevendean. It's
about 29 degrees. It's hot.
It's hot. It's also a suburb of Brighton. So we're just, I think we're about 2 miles from the centre of the city. And so this is a number of different artworks that we've installed here to kind of...
Number one, as you can see.
Yeah. There's so these are facts, and they, as you kind of collect the lines in order, then that forms a poem. So people who want to kind of go on the trail themselves and see that, and you can do that.
If we walk, we can see the whole building.
Yeah. So this was actually the very first building that we installed upon.
Yeah.
This is a community centre, and this area is an area of Moulsecoomb that one of the community groups that we worked with is housed in here, and it was just like a really special spot for us. It was one of the first community centres that we had made a connection with.
Yeah.
And we initially painted the grass as well, but that
as
has
you can see, some
washed
rain
away.
And green has grown.
So the grass painting is an ephemeral thing, obviously, but for the pieces that we put on the buildings are going to be there permanently. Yeah. The initial idea was that this would be a temporary installation and that people would have those things painted over. And delightfully, 99.9% of the people who we've painted on their buildings are going to keep that, so it's kind of wonderful to see that that element is going to remain in the area. So also, no crazy rush to come here, you can wait and come and see it in your own time.
So yeah, this was the first building we started before lockdown and COVID happened. We actually managed to finish this building the day before lockdown, which was an amazing feat really. Yeah,
so this whole project has taken us, we started it in January, and we were doing a big kind of period of research, and we were testing out on this building first of all, and that like Walter said was the day before, and everybody knows at that point in time things were changing daily, and we were really happy to be able to complete this building the day before lockdown, and then we were in the house working on portraits from there in. So we'll take you on a tour, we're going to get in the car.
Follow us and go get number 2, 3, 4 and 5.
Yeah, exactly. So all of the colours.
I like the
colour. Okay. All of the colours are a colour spectrum that, be careful walking down the steps, a colour spectrum that we've used throughout all of the buildings that are here. And this building in particular, we were using a kind of pattern that was relaying an element of tapestry and an element of kind of analogue code as well in there. So that was really a reflection on things that we'd kind of been inspired by in the community, and we felt that the element of tapestry really helped represent that. Here we get in the house. Well done, Phoebe and Walter.
Yeah.
Getting close up of getting everybody in. So, welcome to Golden Gilbert, our car. Not so golden inside, golden on the outside, our workhorse. So we're not used to filming live or at all inside Gilbert, but we're going to drive around the area because Moulsecoomb and Bevendean is quite spread out. And if you haven't been here, then it's an area that is it's kind of nestled in the South Downs, and all of the housing. I'm sure anybody who's kind of familiar with British housing between the kind of 30s and the 50s. Recognise the style of the housing here, and again that was something that really, you know, unavoidably struck us when we first came to visit the area and we were first doing our research and reflections. That was something that we really felt kind of would hold an interruption that was really colourful very well, so we thought, you know, how wonderful this would be if those buildings were, you know, people houses, and how sort of surreal that and joyous that juxtaposition would be. So that was our aim in terms of this interruption, and as we go through, we'll end the tour on the kind of major growth. anybody who hasn't been in this area, then it's kind of quite good to try and sort of orientate you.
So we're going to slowly drive past number 2 and 3, so we won't actually stop, but we'll be coming up shortly on our right hand side. So if you look out through the window.
So you can see the kind of
channel. Yeah, you can see here.
Number 2, and this is
Hodge
Road.
I can just pull up actually outside for a second. We might get out of the car.
And this was a really delightful road to install on.
Yeah, it's had a real sense of community, almost like a festival.
Yes, and this road was where we started installing directly after lockdown, and the inhabitants of the road had like a great sense of community, and we were socially distanced, up on a scaffolding, painting these works on here. And so many people came outside and said, you know, really kind of positive things, and everybody, you know, a consistent comment was like, oh, we all need cheering up, which I think is a sentiment that is felt throughout the country, if not the world, at the moment.
So we're going to drive a bit further along the same road, and number 3 is just a bit further along, as you can see. Just coming up on our right again.
There's a lovely character who lives in here called Donna, and she.
I might just pull up on the left here, and then you can just come back so I can't get past.
Yeah.
There you go. And you can see that behind Zoniel.
Can you see?
Yeah.
So another thing, as we're installing, that I don't know whether it comes across in film, but another thing that really struck us was just the incredible views that these houses have. So you might be able to see some through the houses as we go along, but whilst we're up on a scaffolding there, maybe you can see through there, there's just like the views of the wild woods and these things that just really precious things. I mean, you can't create that out of the blue, can you? It's like you either live in front of something incredibly beautiful or not. And so whilst this neighbourhood had this feeling of very kind of stylized British estate,
I might pull into the centre because there's quite a lot of noise there.
To get the general vibe. So, this centre is...
Became our little home from home.
Yeah, the new centre, and this has been our base throughout, which has been, we've been so utterly grateful for, because this was another community centre which we talked with who ran the centre, the new centre, and they have lots of different things that run in here. There's kind of like refurbs and a thing called Chomp, and then there's something called, I think it's called the Shed Club, where it's just a really wonderful scheme that are very kind of community based in that way. I'll let you turn around and get out. Who knows? Phoebe's doing an incredible
well
job.
Well done, Phoebe. So yeah, if you can walk through the wild flower meadow here, which is very nice.
So, off piece, Walter, I've been following a track. So, this building is used as part of the Good News Centre, and they asked us if we'd like to kind of put some artwork on here. And so this is the first one that we did straight off lockdown.
Yeah, this is the first one after lockdown.
And this has been kind of our base throughout as well, which again is a kind of a testament to the community vibe and the kind of community-centric.
You can see the remnants here. We shaved different pathways through the wild flower meadow that is here. And you can just about see the colour paint. Yeah, you can still see the blues and oranges on here. So you can see what it looked like originally painted on the Fabrica website.
So you can kind of get an idea as well of two of those things that mentioned. One of them, like the placement within the community, you know, this is set right in the midst of the estate. And then around the other side, you have like this incredible view of the South Downs and of the woods that are across the way. And both of these things are really kind of strong elements of the area, aren't they?
Yeah.
Which I think maybe a lot of people who don't really know the area overlook, because it's just kind of got such a strong sense of it being a 19th century estate. But this, can you have a look right around the building? This is where we kind of tested out all the grass canes, which the reason I believe the ones that we've done early have kind of washed down now. And the patterns that we've used. So we did a lot of research with the local community, and that has formed part of the inspiration for the kind of design for buildings, but also that a lot of that fed into the exhibition that's in Fabrica that you can see online. And so lots of the patterns, our immediate concept is that there's something that you can just look at and have, look at it and think that's something that's pretty and kind of joyous and uplifting, maybe by the colours. But
it's kept with the same colour palette, which we kind of tend to actually between project to project as well.
Yeah, but within each pattern, there is a disruption. So you can take it entirely on face value and see it as just a joyous object, or there is kind of like another level that's also fed into the exhibition in Fabrica. And that element of kind of disruption is meant to relate to this idea of apophenia that we have in our minds, where we're constantly trying to put things into groups in our heads. So when we see things, whether they're the same colour or a certain shape, then our minds are kind of working to make that pattern. It isn't necessarily a pattern, so we wanted to kind of disrupt these patterns in there. There's also certain objects that are in there, so it's based around circles and triangles, but when you put them in different ways next to one another, then they can evoke different ideas in your head, whether you think that looks like a flag or it looks like a...
Okay, let's keep moving.
Keep moving. We don't know how long it can take to get around everything. Hopefully it's a beautiful day as well.
Sorry, not one of the cameras, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Right, everyone strapped in.
We're strapped in. Up to the next
block.
I don't know whether you...
So that was number four.
Number four, yeah. The plaque is just... We put the plaque of this one kind of on the outside so that people... don't have to come inside to come up.
You
to
might
the
just
building.
Be able to sit at your left as we come up off the left. You'll be able to sit at the back number four as well. Four is going right. Oh no, someone's stolen it.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay, I haven't literally stolen it. Okay, so now we are going to snake along the roads of Moulsecoomb and Bevendean. So, yeah, where are we going next, Walter?
We're going to, don't know the name of the road, up at Bevendean Crescent. Bevendean Crescent. We're going to Bevendean Crescent. So we're going to go see a van and a house we painted up there. Which is quite fun. So there's small children crossing in front of me, so I'm going to pay attention to that. Yeah.
Hopefully this gives you a really good feeling of how sort of embedded within the community the artwork is, and as we've installed, then it people being outside, and we've kind of we spent the first 2.5 months doing research and speaking to people before lockdown. Since installations started taking place, then we've had a whole other kind of interaction with people, which is so lovely because people are just always super positive. I feel once you so important to carry on with this commission throughout lockdown in that way. So Walter, do you want to take him out there?
Yeah, walk up that way.
Yeah.
Yep, there we go. Just turn the car around again. So.
Technical information there. Just turn the car around.
Yeah, got the camera.
So this is actually, along with this project, what happened a lot of the time was we'd be busy painting. You're going to see house number 6. We actually painted that one before house number 5. But as we were painting it, people would come past and talk to us and interact. They'd go, can you come and paint our house? And this was actually one of the first recommendations just from walking past. Another nice, again, the piece of design is in the circle, the two circles and the triangles. Read into that what you will. We have to be very careful with the scaffolding here because this lovely lady has lots of potatoes growing at the bottom there that you might not see.
Yeah, we've had lots of elements like that, obviously.
You don't expect me doing an art installation.
Yeah, we have certain amount of kit that we can get to. So there are actually lots of people who put their houses towards painting as well. We can even
just astounded by being in this actual neighbourhood is actually how nestled it is in the South Down. It's absolutely amazing. I think people that live here kind of can take it for granted somewhat, but actually one of the very first people that contacted us directly about having a piece of kit at home. And when we were painting the house itself, we thought how nice it would be. She had this lovely little old van here, and she actually went, yeah, why not paint the van as well? So I don't know if you actually reached the baby, you might be able to see them both together.
Place
up to the flat and then we'll move on. Number 6. There is space, there is history, there is her story, there is their story. Yeah, if you do the entire story. Hi, sorry, we're just doing a little film. Sorry.
No worries.
Yeah, let's carry on. Let's go on to number 7. So this isn't actually one part of the numbered series. So we did 12 numbered locations, which were different paintings, either on the grass or on buildings. But then there were other people we met and had connections with that we found stories, really interesting stories, or connections to. And so this lovely house here, so you can see the whole house, we met two lovely ladies, Sylvie and Pearl, like this one here, for instance, with yellow plastic.
As well as the numbered plaques, which form a poem in the home, we also have these plaques that are installed that tell a little bit of an inspiring story. And this story here is three siblings, that one of them that was born here, one of them that lives here still, and one of them that very sadly died here when he was a child. So their brother died here.
But they've lived in this house since it was new, so amazing. So they've been here when this whole housing estate was forming.
Yeah, and there's more about that story. You can kind of look on the website.
Here on the website there's a 3D 360 of inside, and you'll actually be able to hear the narration from Sylvie and Pearl themselves.
Yeah, so they have some really wonderful stories about being here when they were kids, and one of those stories is kind of about they would scrub the doorsteps, and all the local children would
scrub the doorsteps together.
And then once they're finished, they would all get their buckets and throw the water down the street.
There's a slight hill on this street.
To see who went the furthest, whose water went the furthest. And they call them tabbers, which is just like some word that they, I don't know whether they made it up or not, but it was a really kind of delightful insight into how somebody's childhood was here in a different era. And it's a very family-centric place. There's quite a mixture of
I just filmed Zoniel while I put your seatbelt on. So
getting back in.
Yeah. Zoniel, I'm going to put the seatbelt on now.
So the next spot that we're going to, are we going up to the collector's walk or are we going to
Well, that's just down here,
that's
there's a plaque.
Down here.
Yeah, I think.
Okay. I know. Excuse us. We can't remember absolutely everything in the correct order.
Yeah. So the next stop we'll be going to is the Collector's Walk. One of the first groups we met was an art group, local art group that were working here in this Bevendean. Was it the Bevendean or Moulsecoomb? I can't remember.
In Moulsecoomb, the Bevy.
In the Bevy, but I can't remember if it's the Moulsecoomb and Bevy. I thought it's Moulsecoomb and Bevy Art Club.
Yeah.
And Kat, one of the people there, she was very enthusiastic. She'd lived in this place her entire life in the this area. And she took us on a shortcut. It's a left turning here, it's right here, just cars parked in front of it, so you can't turn left.
Let's see if we can get through here.
Anyway.
Yes, an incredibly scenic shortcut.
Which would take you up, instead of having to walk through the housing estate itself, you can actually walk up this path and you come on to the top of the South Downs and come back down the other side. And so since she was small, she took us on this walk and she promised to us that we'd go up
through
that, that's where the start of the walk is. That you would walk up this path here and you would keep walking and you'd come up to a big open space and it would be the South Downs, and you keep walking up the top of the hill till you reach the fence of the reservoir, and you weren't allowed to look back until you got to the fence. So we did this dutifully and it was wonderful, and you can see a video 360 of this on again Fabrica's website. You can click and look on the link of that.
So we've got a plaque that's up here that's about the collector's challenge as well.
There's a plaque here as well you'll be able to find. And our next up will be the Bevy, which is a local hub. It's a community-run pub. I think there's only one of a handful of them actually in the whole of the UK, which is run and owned by the community itself. And so they do amazing sort of lunch clubs for the elderly and food banks, and obviously hosting the art club, which was where
they
we met.
They host
loads of different things.
It's interesting. You can look it up as well. The Bevy itself is
a very
interesting place.
Yeah.
And the first spot of it, so we did two small pieces on the Bevy, and one of them is from a kind of yellow plaque series, which was about telling stories. And then the other one, this one you can see here. Can you see that okay?
Yeah.
Do you want to get out and have a look here right there? So this tells the story of where the original gate of Bevy was. And I'll just put it in a bit further down. So the original gate was put here, so that it was put on the plans to effectively kind of hoodwink the planners that the building was actually in Bevendean. So this road here that we're on is the divide between Moulsecoomb and Bevendean. So that side is Moulsecoomb and this side is Bevendean. And so they kind of quite successfully managed to hoodwink the planners, because Moulsecoomb at that point in time was an estate of temperance. So you weren't allowed any alcohol in it. So they kind of got away with that one by building a pub in an estate of temperance, which we thought was just such a fascinating story. And so we've put in a temporary artwork there that's there for the...
So the paint we used on that was different to the other houses. That's actually an eco-temporary paint we've used for other projects. Which we've covered galleries with before. And so what will happen when it rains, it will slowly wash away and it's totally 100% eco and biodegradable.
And then due to kind of the size and shape of the bevy, we couldn't cover the whole thing. So we've done a little artwork on the front.
The entrance here.
That you can see there. And you can see like the themes of the circles and the triangles. And this is quite busy because it has obviously so many things on it, because it's the front of a community building. Okay, yeah, I'll wait.
Just give us
a go past.
Also
can keep you entertained.
I'll keep you entertained, as you can see. So, Bevy has become a real hub for the actual entire area, as we said before. So this is one of the places we spent a lot of time researching in January and February. A couple of key people here. We met Helen, who was great at organising and finding other people for us in which portrait series. If you've not seen them, if you access them from Fabrica website, we did a whole host of series of portraits where people were anonymous. It was giving a story of themselves. And so the next stop we're going to go to is it's called the Avenue. And so this is generally the first point of call when you come into this area. And it's a kind of a big, huge one-way system. And in the middle, there are three green spaces which are almost a kilometre long in length. And so we decided it would be great to paint these with designs using grass paint. In fact, when we first came to this area, way in January, this is where we didn't know the rest of the estate. We drove into here, and it was something about the geography of it and it sitting in a valley that just made us want. The idea came almost instantly to paint the houses. Painting the grass came as we worked on the project, and hopefully you're going to get a good chance. Sorry, it's a really noisy van here. You'll get the sense of scale of it, because we'll get out of the car and we'll walk the distance, and it's probably going to take us a good 10 minutes to walk across it all. But also you'll need to, if you look at the drone footage, that's when you really get to see the scope and scale of the design. We'll be there in about 2 seconds, we're going to pull up.
Yeah, strangely the street, there met a lot of people on the street as well. We just passed a house that was another person who's a portrait. So many people that we met as we've walked around and just been talking to people who were kind of happy to talk on the street. Should we pull up at this end, Walter?
Yeah, but just on the left, I would have thought.
On the left?
Yeah,
okay.
In an action on double yellow, because we're only about 15 minutes walking. Or are we going to do them separately, get back in the car?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, okay, so just pull up on the left.
So all of this is like a one-way system around these greens, and we just thought it would be quite amazing to paint the green space. And each element is three separate green spaces.
Everybody out. Okay.
Whilst we were in the middle of doing this, obviously the pandemic affected us all.
changed the design somewhat until each of these piles were 2 metres apart. Because of COVID, we decided to make this back when there was a 2 metre rule. As you can see, the grass has grown quite a bit already, but I don't know if you can see the scale. These paths go as like, how far? About 300 metres.
Yeah, 276 metres the length of this.
And so it zigzags in and out. The best way to really explore it is via the drone footage and visiting it, obviously, running up and down. And someone cycled it the other day, so that thing, when you're up a little bit higher, and you're going at a pace, you really get a good take. We've just spent days painting it.
But it's a series of things on flag pathways, and these are in the spectrum of the rainbow, and we changed this design to represent this moment in time and to kind of capture this element of storytelling and put it really kind of literally in this context. I mean, the rainbow is something that's obviously such a joyous thing. It's naturally it's joyous, but it's also represented things that have been really about solidarity in different ways, and at this point in time it has also come to represent something new. So we wanted to kind of put that into the story, because that is very much what's happened now, and it's been a really long time to kind of install all of those things with us here. And I hope people enjoyed wandering along it.
I thought I might bring our co-host for this one.
Blossom over there. Oh, I was going to just put it around the corner so you don't have to do that. Yeah.
Right, our co-host and rainbow sponsor here, Blossom. Sorry, put the seatbelt safety first. Has got a few words to say. She's been with us the whole time through every installation, and
enjoyed
the sunshine and the green spaces. What do you think, Blossom?
Yes.
Yeah. as we move along now,
you'll see how large it is, the whole green as well. It's such
a maybe if
space.
You look as we drive, you can see the kind of sense of scale. So when we first came here, it was these houses surrounding it that we thought it would be wonderful to be able to inject some colour into this.
And it felt very much like an amphitheatre, didn't it, as well?
Yeah.
Because it has a sense of like that people can perceive this from above as
and
well.
If you look to the left, there's another house coming up that we painted, which is one of the last ones we actually painted.
Yeah.
Here, just on the left.
Just go and drive through the
middle
of this one.
Which one?
So that you can see it as
we
go, and then we'll park up at the other end.
Oh, the runway?
So if you go, you can see
it
from here.
Yeah, we're going to go that way. If you look through the front windscreen on the other side, you should be able to see it.
Yeah.
You can film as we go.
Yeah, so this
visit. These are the plaques you'll see, simple acts of wonder. I'll come and let you out.
Generally told from that perspective of like the story behind the plane, but what really something that could kind of effectively abstractly tell a story of how we, about storytelling itself and how we relate to stories. Are you just jumping?
Yeah. I'm demonstrating.
You know, you've done a good job, Walter. I'm so distracted by him. But wow, getting a walk on to the wall. So we thought, you can see this from above as well, but this you can see as you walk through it too. Certain areas that we have a mixture of colours, and then there are other areas that are just solely colourful areas. Say, for instance, there's pink and red, and those colours next to each other look quite different from, say, the red next to the blue, which are two primary colours. And And that was just like a really simplistic nod to how we perceive one another in the situations that we are perceived, and how, you know, we are different people in different environments, and different people kind of look different in different environments.
I look different to you.
Yeah,
it's a little nod to your brain hates to find a pattern in here. It's just like, it's one of these things where you're playing with people slightly, where you're using the colours, but it took quite a lot of thought in the placement of each colour so that there's no real pattern to be found. And so this is number 11, I was just going to say, on the plaque here, because I forgot that number 12 is actually Fabrica. So we won't be showing you that. So this will be our final stop of the day.
All of us are forever.
So, from Moulsecoomb and Bevendean, I'd like to say goodbye.
Yeah, I didn't realise if people can ask questions or not.
No.
No, they don't ask questions. You could email us a question if you have a question.
You can email Zoniel.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed it. Yeah. And
our whistle stop tour of Moulsecoomb and Bevendean. Yeah, yeah, have a look on Fabrica website or come down. Yeah.
You can come and experience elements of this in 3D, and or you can come and experience it in real life if you're in the area. We kind of, at the moment, we're kind of leaving this here for the locals to experience. And if you're local to the area, then do come and take a walk. It's so much space here.
Out of shot.